This video tutorial I will explain how to configure data source using JNDI in Spring Boot application. Here you can see the Spring Boot application with the folder structure. Here you can see the pom.xml. We are planning to create var for this Spring Boot application and deploy it in the external Tomcat. So here I have specified packaging as var. And here I have included the dependencies like web, JDBC, MySQL connector Java, and Tomcat. And scope is provided because we are planning to deploy the var in the external Tomcat. Next step is configuring JNDI on the Tomcat server. To do that, inside Tomcat server, we can see conf folder. Inside conf folder, we can see server.xml file. Open this file and add this configuration under global naming resources tag. And in resource tag, we can specify all the configuration details about the database. Here you can see URL of the database and username and password of the database, driver class name, and JNDI name. Here you can see Tomcat folder. Inside that, you can see conf folder. And here you can see server.xml file. And whatever I have mentioned in the PPT, here you can see. Next, in application.properties file, we have to specify the JNDI name. And here you can see the JNDI name, JDBC/testDB. And same thing is specified here. And one more configuration we have to do, that is inside configuration folder, we can see contacts.xml file, and open that file, and we have to add resource link tag. And here we have to specify JNDI name and global attribute. And global attribute value should be same as JNDI name, which we have configured in server.xml file. Inside conf folder, here you can see contacts.xml file. And here I have added resource link tag, JNDI name. Here you can see org.db, and it has employee table, and employee table has two records. We will see how to get all these records from employee table. Here I have defined the class employee, and it has four properties: ID, name, age, and salary, which are equivalent to columns in the employee table. And getter and setter methods for these four properties. And here I have overridden toString method. Here I have defined a class employee repository, which is repository class. And here I have defined JDBC template, which is auto-wired. So when Spring Boot application starts, it will create a JDBC template object and inject here, and it has a find all method, and here I am calling a query method of JDBC template object and passing the select query, select star from employee table and the employee row mapper object. This method returns a list of employee objects. Here I have defined a class employee row mapper, which implements row mapper interface and provide implementation of map row method. And this method maps the result set output to the employee object. Suppose there are two rows are there, then this method will be called two times by this query method. Here I have defined a class employee controller, which is a REST controller. And here I have defined employee repository, which is auto-wired. And here I have defined the method getEmployees. To call this method, we have to send request to this path. And method is get method. And in this method, I am calling findAll method of employee repository object. This method returns list of employee objects, and that will be returned back to the client. In this example, we are planning to deploy the Spring Boot application in the external Tomcat. So for that, we have to do like this. We have to define the class application and which extends Spring Boot servlet initializer and provide implementation of configure method. So that when Tomcat server starts, it calls the main method of this application class and start the Spring Boot application. Next, we will create the var file of this Spring Boot application. Use the command mvn clean install. Var file is created in this location. Refresh. Here you can see the var file is created. Copy this. In Tomcat folder, you can find web apps folder, paste it here. Next, we will start the Tomcat server. And here you can see the Tomcat server is started, and along with the Spring Boot application also started. Next, we will send the request. Tomcat server is started in 8080 port. Copy the Spring Boot application path. Copy the REST path, paste it here, send the request. And we got output. And here we got employee list. There are two rows are there, and we got two employee objects in the JSON format. Next, we will send the request using postman. Here I have given the request URL. and the method is get method. Click on send. And here you can see the output. We got two employee objects in JSON format because two rows are present in employee table. And status is 200 OK. You can get Java source code link for each video in the description section of the video. Here you can see the description section. Click on show more. And here you can see the Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.